great. Yes.
Amen.
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 But you are a chosen generation.
Amen.
A royal priesthood.
Yes.
And holy nation.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
A peculiar people.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
That you should show forth the praise of him who had called you out of darkness. Into his marvelous life. There's nothing like the church. Nothing like the church. And how unique and significant it is. Because as we understand the church that Christ built, is made up of individuals.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Who have confessed a credible faith.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
In Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And I mean a credible faith. And when I think in terms of the church, and we have certainly been discussing it last few days concerning nothing like the church. The church had stood the test.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Over 2,000 years.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. People talk down on the church.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Talk about how you ought to act. They ain't doing nothing.
Come on.
But obviously they forgot one thing.
All right.
That the Lord said, upon this rock, I'll build my church.
Yes.
And the gates of hell cannot overturn it.
Yes, man.
Obviously, Satan had forgot that.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. All right. Jesus says what he means, and he means what he said. And I lifted concern to remind the local church of some things that you already know.
All right.
Yes, sir.
Number one, we are been invited and accepted the invitation to be in the royal family.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir. Yeah, I'm looking at some royalties here.
All right.
I don't know I don't know what you think about yourself. But I'm just talking about what the Bible says.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. If you've been born again.
Yeah.
Yeah, you are in the royal family.
Yeah.
You're not just somebody struggling and staggering around with no hope.
Amen.
We have special resources.
Yes.
And our resources come down, not come up.
All right.
So we talked about that because we are a chosen generation.
Yes.
Royal priesthood.
Yes.
The very fact that God Himself had chose us, it means that we are placed in a unique position. We are chosen not only for Him to take us to heaven, but the purpose why we are still here is in the text. That we could show forth the praise of Him that have called you out of darkness and place you in His marvelous light. I want to say it again. There's nothing like the church.
Amen.
I don't care where you go, where you come from. Amen. There is nothing like the church.
Yes.
And the uniqueness of the church is that God channels His word.
Yes, sir.
Through the ministry of the church. So actually, the church has an awesome responsibility to carry out the assignment that Jesus placed on the church in Matthew 28, 18, 19, and 20, when He said, "All authority has been given unto me." To go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Then it added the second teach, where it said, teach them, meaning making disciples, to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you, and lo, I'm with you always, even to the end of the earth. So ministry that God has called us not to fulfill it between in these walls, but as a ministry is to reach out to the world. And reaching out to the world, the message number one is a message of love. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son. That's the message of the church. It's a message of mercy. God is a God of mercy. But it's also a message of judgment. God will call you into accountability. Are y'all listening to me? And it is a message of grace. Y'all remember Ephesians 2 and 8, by grace, we're saved, faith, that's not about sin. It's a message of grace, but it's also a message of forgiveness. But it also, we are carrying the message of salvation. And I heard Paul was saying this a little bit ago. He's our Savior. And I heard y'all witnessing. Not only is He our Savior, but He has a message. We have a message of hope. You can only find hope among church folks. Now, some of us, we don't act like it sometimes, but as you stare up just a little bit, you can find hope among church folks. And these messages are important because the world needs to hear and be responsible for their own action. Because God is calling each of us into accountability. Therefore, don't misunderstand the value of the church. But what I really want to talk about, the man that gave the origin of the church.
All right.
And that's Jesus the Christ. Nobody like Jesus. Now I want to tell you, you
can search heaven and earth.
Yes, sir.
But you cannot find anybody that can measure up with Jesus Christ.
Yes, yes.
And I think sometimes how we sometimes allow worldly surrounding snatch our joy.
That's right. That's right.
When because we are a chosen generation.
Yes, sir.
God done picked us out and placed us in the world that we could be the truth in the dark world.
Yes,
are y'all listening to me?
Yes, sir.
And yet, many times we allow the world to dictate when we ought to say, have mercy. When we ought to say, Lord, help us. We are so timid until it's almost like we're afraid to cry, Lord, have mercy.
That's right. That's
right. I want to tell you, Jesus understood our feebleness. He is the Christ.
Yes.
He is God's only son. God doesn't have but one boy. And that's Jesus. And we have to honor him for who he is. Jesus is the only man that come down and presented God's glory to a world that hated him. He's the only one. That came down through generations.
Yes, sir.
In order to bring his daddy's glory here on earth. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Frederick, for glorifying your daddy. But that's what Jesus did.
Yes.
He brought God's glory down here to us on earth.
Yes.
And the only condition is that you believe in him.
Yes.
The brother read earlier, with the heart,
man
believe unto righteousness.
Yes.
And with the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. So you don't have to us sin or de-sin, he's right here. The Bible said the word is near you. It is close to your opening your mouth. And that's what's so beautiful. That's what beauty is about Jesus Christ. Jesus is the one that made it available.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The church, as we know it, could not exist apart from Jesus Christ. Jesus the Christ. Jesus the Christ. Jesus the Christ. Jesus the Christ. I want to slow down a little bit. Y'all don't rush me.
Take your time.
A little bit. Because we talked about what access would the church have to God. We have a personal line.
Yes.
To God. You don't need a high priest to pray for you.
Yes, sir.
Jesus fixed that. At Calvary. You remember reading when he died, the veil of the temple was torn down. And what happened? He tore down the middle wall of partition that kept man from going directly to God. You don't need a high priest. The fact about it, you check out salvation, is some preaching in all of us. You are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation. And the purpose of him crowning us with that honor, crowning us with that glory, that we would not be ashamed to proclaim his truth, to show forth his goodness, to show forth his grace, to show forth his love, to show forth his mercy, to show forth his salvation. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. We have been called to magnify him. So there's nobody like Jesus.
Amen.
He's the one. According to John 1 and 14, where it says, and the word was made flesh and dwell among us.
Yes.
The word is John is almost like he was looking through some binoculars. When he said, we beheld his glory.
Yes. 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 Yes.
That are the only begotten Son of God.
Yes. Yes.
Full of grace.
Yes.
And truth.
Yes.
Yes.
He the only man.
Yes.
That had grace and truth.
Yes.
Moses was called to bring truth. But Jesus overseed Moses.
Yes.
He brought grace and truth.
Right.
Moses mastered the law.
Yes.
But Jesus said that I'm gonna fix it so.
Yes.
That you won't be cursed by the law.
Yes.
Because the law said that the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God works in grace, y'all. And it came out. So what Jesus did at Calvary, he actually took the sting out of death. Robbed the grave from the victory. God for the story. Stayed when he died. He stayed in the heart of the earth for 3 days. But every Sunday morning, brothers and sisters, listen. Sunday morning ought to be resurrection morning. You ought not have to wait till Easter. Praise God. Sunday morning is resurrection morning.
Resurrection,
because when God raised him out of the grave, he raised him up. And when God raised him up, he raised me up.
Come on.
Justified.
Yes.
Nobody like Jesus. Nobody can even come close to matching who Jesus is. Can you imagine disrobing himself?
Yes.
Coming down through 42 generations. Yes. And God was searching for somebody because he loved humanity. And he was searching for somebody to go man bun. And he couldn't find just like a lot of us. He was looking for somebody.
Yes, sir.
To stand at the gate.
Yes, sir.
But it's kind of hard to find a human to stand in the gateway. But Jesus said, Dad, I'll go. Let me pull off my robe.
Yes,
and I'm going to travel down 42 generations. Put me off in a little time. You know, Bethlehem. I don't want anybody knowing tonight. Born by a Virgin Mary. Don't let anybody talk you out of believing that he was born by a Virgin Mary. The devil would try to fool you and try to trick you and trap you. But he was born. So Mary was his earthly mother. But God was his heavenly father. So he was born for a purpose. And he said it himself, I come to seek and to save that book we love. One preacher said when Jesus was walking around here on earth, people couldn't die.
No,
they couldn't die. Because they had the living word. They couldn't die. He got invited to a funeral.
Right now.
Have to die.
Yes.
And I thought about it.
Yep, but
all right, all right.
And the answer to that question,
yes.
While he was up there, he looked down.
Yes.
And saw our scene.
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
He looked down and investigated our circumstances.
Yeah. All right.
He looked down and realized our guilt.
Yes.
Are y'all praying with me?
Yes. Yes.
He looked down and knew our despair. He looked down and put our burden in a balance.
Yes.
He weighed our burden.
Yes.
Yeah, he looked down.
He looked
down. He witnessed our weakness.
Yeah. All
right.
He observed our hopelessness.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, he realized that mankind was helpless, lost, and destined to hate. Unless he originate and establish a perfect and complete plan of salvation.
Yes. Yes.
And I want to tell you, salvation is a complete. Furthermore, he kept looking. He looked down and he surveyed the valley. He measured the mountain. And he calculated the loss. He looked down and he comprehended our sorrow. He's still looking down. He taking inventory of all our mistakes. Are y'all not praying with me? He's still looking down. He counted all of our failures. But as he looked down, he visualized our destiny. That's why when he came down, he came down to seek that which was lost. I want to tell you, there's nobody but Jesus. Ain't nobody do me like Jesus. Ain't nobody do me like the Lord. What a wonderful Savior. What a wonderful God. Was able to look beyond our faults. And saw our need. My older sister, Oakley McBride, passed some few years ago.
Come on, Pastor.
But she sung a song that she loved to sing. And that song was, "You're Gonna Need Jesus." You're gonna need Jesus. You're gonna need the Lamb of God to walk around your bedside. I don't know about you tonight, but I want to proclaim to you. I don't know where you are in life. He's a friend that will stay closer than a brother. You may need somebody to just walk with you. I want to tell you that he's a God that will never leave you nor forsake you. Not only will he walk with you, but God, he'll talk with you. But he'll help you if you're in need. Can I get a witness? I don't know about y'all tonight, but he's a God can handle any situation. He's a burden barrier. He's a heavy load carrier. He's a mind fixer. Showing up a mind regulator. your mind. Good God Almighty. What about is that? Keep your mind stayed on Jesus. I wonder why there's some is crying out like that. Then I thought about what Paul said in Philippians 2:5, said, let this mind be in you that was also in Christ Jesus. Good God Almighty. I found out that when you're operating in Jesus' mind, trouble don't last always. Weeping only endures for a night. But joy, if anybody in the house, joy shall not come in the morning. Good God Almighty, when you got the mind of Jesus, you can persevere when everything else is falling around you. He ain't going to make everything all right. If you got the mind of Jesus, you keep your eye on the sparrow, because he knew his heavenly Father. See everything he do, every word he said. Do you remember when he coming out the garden, when they arrested him? They said, who? Jesus said, who are you looking for? And they said, Jesus. And he said, I'm he. And the Bible said they fell back to the ground. Good God Almighty. Then he got up and said, who are you looking for? He said, Jesus. He said, I'm he. Let these others go. And the Bible said they took him and marched him. Good God Almighty. I thought about what he went through. I don't know about you, but what he went through for me. They marched him from judgment to judgment hall. They lied on him. They spit on him. They beat him. They put thorns on his head. Good God Almighty. They put a crown, a thorn on his head. And they put a cross on his shoulder. And they marched him. But God got to heal. Is anybody in the house tonight can hear the cry that went out? But Jesus bear the cross alone. And all the world go free. Oh, no. There's a cross for everybody. There's a cross for you and me. Jesus said, no man take my life, but I lay it down for my friends. Ain't God all right? Ain't he all right? If you have the mind of Christ, you would love one another with no strings attached. He loved us when we wasn't lovable. He did things for us when we really didn't deserve it. And I thought about old man David. David said, grace and mercy. Surely grace and mercy. But wrapped up in the mind of Jesus. And if you got Jesus, you don't need nobody else. You can talk to him. He's able. Is anybody in the house beside me know that he is able? He's able to lift up out of here. If you are weak, he can give you strong. If you are sick, he's a healer. Good God Almighty. If you don't have any money in your pocket, you won't worry about it. Because my God shall supply all of your needs. Good God in heaven. Thank God all right. That's why Paul cried out, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. I want to say, notice tonight, if you're in sin, good God Almighty, he's a sin forgiver. If you're burdened down, he's a burden barrier. If you're in sorrow, he knows exactly what you're going through. Jim, I say he's a man of sorrow, well acquainted with what you're going through. So saints, that word, we've been called to praise him, but that praise means that he is superior. That praise means that he is to be reverenced. That praise means that the Holy Ghost, the right opinion. If you can't praise him without the Holy Ghost, you can use some words, but you'll never reach heaven. You can't praise him, but the Holy Ghost can. Ain't God all right? If the Spirit is in you, God's Spirit is in me, we can send up holy praise, because it's really not me, but the Holy Spirit speaking to me.
searches the world over, but you'll never find anybody that can do like Jesus. Nobody can hold me like Jesus. Nobody can love me like Jesus. Nobody can talk to me like Jesus. Nobody can kiss me like Jesus. Nobody can give me comfort like Jesus.
You can go ahead and say hallelujah anyhow. When things are not going well, just say hallelujah anyhow. When things are looking bad, just hallelujah anyhow. You ought to have some anyhow praises. I don't know where you are tonight, but you ought to have a praise.
Of this holy nation. That means a nation that is set apart. And we are the one to offer up praise for the one who called you out of darkness, for the one who lifted you out of the shackles of sin. Sin was tying you down. But Jesus said, the Son of Man came to set you free. And if you've been set free, yeah, you ought not to mind praising him tonight. You ought not to mind praising him tonight. Because nobody, not only like the church, but nobody like Jesus.
Nobody.
He can have that.